Hi, welcome back to our training session. I am Hitendra Kumar Shah, pharmaceutical compliance consultant, CGMP trainer and auditor from NADH Plus GXP compliance services. First of all, I would like to thank all of you who like my earlier videos. With your due respect, our today's discussion topic is data integrity and audit trail review. This is a big topic and needs a lot of explanation for understanding. Hence, I have made this video in two parts. Let us discuss part one with the focus on data integrity. I would like to request you to watch this video till end as we are going to discuss practical approach to avoid data integrity issues. There are many guidelines on data integrity. WHO, PEAKS, US FDA, MHRA, etc. But still, many of us are confused with this data integrity concept. Many persons, in case of minor error or documentation error, refer as data integrity, which is a quite serious concern. In ethics, integrity is regarded as the honesty and truthfulness or accuracy of one's action. Having integrity means doing the right thing in a reliable way. To understand integrity in a better way, I will give one small example. Consider there are two persons, one is G and other is John. G always speak either lie or without logic or speak without base, while John will speak always truth, logical and always speak on the basis of ground reality. Now tell me, to whom you will believe, G or John? Of course John, because John is honest and truthful while G is not. In such a case, we can say that there is a integrity problem with G while John is complying the integrity requirement. Now, if similar kind of question related to the truthfulness is raised with respect to generated data, it indicates that there is a data integrity problem. Here, data means paper data or electronic data or hybrid data. Hybrid data means the data constitutes paper data as well as electronic data. Now, the question is, what is the measure of data integrity, or how we can ensure the data generated is compliant to integrity requirement? The answer to this is, as you are aware about the concept ALCOA++, which means attributable, legible, contemporaneous, original, accurate, available, enduring, consistent and complete. If data generated complies to these requirements, your data is compliant to principles of data integrity. I will not discuss much on this ALCOA++ concepts, considering that you all are aware about this, but yes, I will discuss how you can protect yourself from data integrity or potential data integrity problems. So, if you evaluate that why there is a data integrity problem in current scenario, you will come to know that data integrity breaches are either due to technical aspects or behavioral aspect. For practical implementation of data integrity requirements, we need to perform below tasks. For example, we need to perform the risk assessment. I would like to suggest to perform the risk assessment of all unit operations and generated data with respect to practices. During this risk assessment, you can evaluate potential causes of data integrity breaches. Or for easy understanding, you can consider potential causes which may lead to raise question about authenticity of the generated data in line with ALCOA++ principle. Once you identify the potential causes, as a proactive approach, it is very easy to take either procedural control or automated control so as to avoid possible data integrity breaches. The next one is facility and resources. We need to evaluate whether adequate facility or resources are provided to do the job or not. Personnel also plays very important role. Evaluate the personnel with respect to competency, workload or pressure. Next point is culture. evaluate whether the organization culture is supporting compliance or organization still believes that compliance role is only for important during inspection. Record and reference availability. Evaluate the reference procedures, SOPs, standard test procedures, batch record instructions are easily accessible and easily understood by the user. Also, the logbooks, forms or batch record analytical data sheets used for recording the observations or the results are readily available and easily accessible to the user or not. The next one is oversight. You need to have quality oversight procedure where not only the shop floor person but also all key managers, senior managers and even the top management should have a secret schedule. The senior person should visit the shop floor for surprise checks and evaluate the generated data is complying the data integrity requirement or not. You can form data integrity checklist so that during quality oversight the same checklist can be followed. Procedure for data integrity. You can have SOP for reporting, investigation and CAPA for data integrity observation. And of course, very important thing is all personnel should be trained on data integrity escalation and reporting practices. And final last point is audit trail review. The audit trail review is a big topic. We'll not able to discuss here more with this same video, but yes, I promise you that we will discuss this video or we will discuss this audit trail review in the next part of the video. These are the major aspects to comply the requirements. Further, if you need to evaluate the compliance level of your organization, we can perform the thorough gap analysis of your organization. We can provide suitable training and pragmatic approach towards compliance. You can contact us through the numbers or the emails displayed on the screen. Further, I would like to inform you that we provide audit and compliance services, which includes all these services. I request you to share this video to all your colleagues so that they can also get benefit with this video. If you are interested in next videos, you can subscribe our YouTube channel. Let me tell you, subscribing the YouTube channel is absolutely free of cost. Further, if you are interested in any other topic, please feel free to contact us. Thank you so much and ensure all-time compliance.